Learning medicine is not an easy thing. Take your time and enjoy life. Not only the studies, the other things you may remember for your lifetime. Actually, this medical faculty was originally planned in 1992, although we started it 1993. I did my A-levels in 1990 because of this backlog. We had to stay for 3 years. And I never applied Sri Jayawardenepura University medical faculty in any of these UGC documents. But suddenly we got a letter saying you are selected to Sri Jayawardenepura University medical faculty. We didn't know what to do and we were fighting against that. But I thought it was a wrong decision at that time. There were 140 students initially. But finally, only 120 passed out because some didn't come. Originally planned not only to give degrees to medical undergraduates but also to other BSc nursing and BSc pharmacy, all these were included. From the beginning, it is Faculty of Medical Sciences. We never had medical faculty logo in our faculty. Yeah, actually when we came, we had nothing. So we had to learn except medicine, everything. If you know this graduate studies building, it was the office as the Faculty of Medical Sciences. Although we came in March, we started medical curriculum in November. At the same time, we got ragged by all other faculties during that period. That is why we decided we are not going to rag any of y'all. Our own buildings came after 1995. Because the first batch, we are all in the same boat. So we don't know what will happen. We didn't know whether we are getting a MBBS or not and whether it will get recognized and lot of issues because SLMC should recognize our degree. So we were in the same boat. So it made a very great bond between the first students of the first batch. At the same time, staff also has the same thing because they were working for the, we and staff both working for the same aim to get recognition. Luckily, Professor Carlo Fonseca did physiology lectures for us, Professor Colvin Gunaratne did physiology lectures for us, and even Professor Nandadada Kodagoda, very prominent character in the forensic field, did forensic for us. So we didn't miss anything. Even anatomy, Professor Panditaratna from Colombo Medical Faculty did anatomy for us. So we had a very good lecture teachers and very good training. So those are the things. Except this uncertainty, except this whether our degree will get recognized kind of feeling, all the things are good, I think. And yeah, other than that, the batch trips. It's a real experience, the batch trips, because from the first we went to Sigiri Dambulla and then the Hanthan as you all, that is a tradition kind of thing. For the first 2 years we did medicine, our lecture halls were from the science faculty. From the first batch, second batch, third batch, we got the first place in the common merit list. There are a lot of consultants and not only here, in UK and kind of thing, and in one of our batchmates is very, very good at doing this robotic surgery, VOG, in UK, and psychiatrists are there, and lot of prominent figures are there, and surgeons are there. I am the only pediatrician, but lot of physicians, lot of surgeons and radiologists, lot of people are there. So actually, we didn't have buildings in our own and we used to be in the gym, we used to be in this open area and all these things. So we used to, the students, our batchmates used to go to this gym and all these things, play table tennis and all these things. They took part in this sports activity, but other than that, we never had this lot of committees kind of things. The first one we had is our talents show with the art circle. We did a film festival to fundraising one because we wanted to have this book scholarship. That is the one, same one which is continuing up to now, and for the student welfare thing from the union. Infrastructure wise, building wise, facilities wise, it has massively increased, and the quality of life in the university is very very much improved. Actually, they plan to have the Jayawardenepura General Hospital as our teaching hospital, but because it's a semi-government kind of thing, there were issues. Colombo South Teaching Hospital became a teaching hospital from Kalubovila General Hospital because of us, but we didn't have a building for prof unit. So initially our prof units were in, if you can remember, the clinic building. The clinic building, the rooms were the wards, prof unit, and later on with time they developed this prof unit. From the beginning, Sri Jayawardenepura and Colombo South were there, but Homagama was affiliated was very, very, very recently. One important thing unique about this is this student-teacher relationship. If you because actually we know each other kind of thing. Sometimes the first year, second year, we may be not knowing, but definitely the pre-clinical teachers are knowing you all. And when they are coming to the third, fourth year, final year, although not by name to call this and that, but we know about you all. And even now, and as a teacher, for because I'm from 2002, I am working as a teacher in this university. And when I go out somewhere, in anywhere in Sri Lanka, any hospital, I know that there's a person I can rely on because our graduates are there. This bonding is the main thing. Take your time and enjoy, and do have a balanced life.